one. My name is Caitlin Brown, and this is my first sports podcast. I want to start today with talking about the manager situation with the Reds. There's many different ways the Reds could go. They could hire Jim Riddleman as the head coach and take the interim tag off. And they could also go out and search for managers that were not managing this year, but are still really good coaches. Or the Reds could look at managers of playoff teams, and after the playoffs, they could go after somebody like Terry Francona, who was a Red and has ties to this area. Or we can go after Aaron Boone, who, even though he is being paid more than the Reds can pay him, he has the connection of this being his hometown and hometown team, as well as the fact that he was a Red for a long period of time. Or one other direction the Reds could go in is looking within their own organization and looking outside the box. You may consider Torquay Miller, and I know a lot of people would question that, but you have to remember that the reason they did not keep Torquay Miller up as a major league catcher is because he was a great second pitching coach and leader on the Louisville Bats team. And he was so valuable as another coach that they needed to keep him down and help develop the the next generation of best players. Now, the next thing I want to know is which way would you go as far as hiring a manager for the Reds? The next subject I want to talk about today is the recent showing of Michael Lorenzen as a starting pitcher for the first time in 3 years, and how he's looked in those first two starts. The first start was just sensational. He threw 4 innings of 1 run but 0 earned run baseball. The second game, he did allow 4 runs, but a lot of the hits he gave up were ground balls just out of the reach of his infielders. And that's not his fault, really. He did his job by getting a ground ball. And the first 2 innings, when he was in trouble, he got himself out of trouble. And that is the number one thing that is necessary for a starting pitcher, because if they can't get themselves out of trouble, you're going to be burning your bullpen every time they start a game. So the question is, do you think Michael Lorenzen deserves a start in the rotation next year? Now, one thing you have to think about is, does he need to develop another pitch to be a starter, such as a slider, to be effective when he goes to start the third round in the batting order? The next thing I want to talk about is how close is FC Cincinnati from a number one seeded team for the playoffs to a number one seeded MLS team, and how do we get there? How many of our current players do we keep? And how many MLS players do we go after? For a contract, and how do you think FC Cincinnati has what it takes to win the USL Cup this season? Well, I'm hoping, really hoping, that they have what it takes to win the whole thing. But I'm a little nervous about the defense, whether or not they can hold it together for that many player games to win the whole thing. But we'll just have to wait and see. Now, a question regarding FC Cincinnati is about their stadium. Why are they only building a stadium with a capacity for 35,000 people when in order to host any World Cup soccer games, CONCACAF soccer games, or Olympic soccer games, you have to have a stadium with at least 45,000 seats. And to have Paul Brown Stadium host the 2022 World Cup is just really a shame when we are have a brand new stadium built for a brand new MLS team, and we are not going to be able to use that stadium, which isn't cheap by any means. We are not going to be allowed to use that for any of the world top teams. When we hold the world top, and that is just a outrage, if you ask me. If you're spending all this money to begin with, spend a little more so that brand new stadium can be shown off to the world during the world top. Now, thank you for watching. This is all I have time for today. If you have any comments, I would love to hear them, and I hope you listen again.